Thank you, Trey. Sarah, I know you're going to come up. Thank you, Sarah, for serving. And I'd like to start by looking back a little bit. We've had a wonderful group of people joining us up here. This Monday, Clay Brown, longtime headmaster, and the reason I'm here, Farrell Singleton. Let's get a little round of applause. You look around this stuff and Carpain over there getting a little nervous because they probably went to Mr. Singleton's office once or twice, I believe. Oh, no, I'm sorry. Just to say hello. That's then Don Caskey. Some of y'all seniors over here remember Mr. Caskey. Thank him, longtime head of our upper school. People we have ever known. Ruth Ben Hunter, whose prayers. Prayers for each and every one of you are a blessing that we can't even imagine. Thank you all for coming. And Seth Viney's up here somewhere. He didn't want to be over there. Coach Viney, welcome back. It's neat having grandparents come in and visit us. All right. And thanks, Coach Viney. One of the things we look at every day here is, again, as Trey said, you wake up and say, thank you for this day. But when we come on campus, I know that Mr. Peffel and I have had this conversation for years. What's the most important thing we do? Well, we better start the year with the most important thing you do every day, and that's to be honest. Because in this day and age of instant gratification, sitting there staring at your phone, sending out a text, doing all the things that don't matter in this world, we need to be very cognizant of what the difference is between a great person and an average person. And it's a very simple choice that you make. Your parents can't make it for you, your teachers can't make it for you. We will start this year with a ceremony Mr. McCann will talk about. But it's not just a ceremony that ends when you walk away. And often, too sadly, that's what happens in this world, and it happens here. And this year, I want you take notice of what this ceremony is about. Be kind, be honest, and be your best. And speaking of the best, I'd like to have the class of 2017 stand up, please. They spent the last 2 days at Ms. Marshall, the college counselors, getting ready for what will happen after this year. But what's more important is something I said briefly to them yesterday. Every one of these students look up to y'all. So we ask you to be honest, be kind, be the best. You will be the models this year. Not just in here, when you walk off our campus, when you compete in academic ball, in shooting plays, whatever you do, whenever you leave, you represent Lakeview Academy, you represent yourself, your family, and our school. So class 2017, I'm proud of y'all. Now I'd like to introduce Mr. Cannon.
We're beginning the 10th year of having an honor code, honor council here at Lakeview Academy. And throughout that time, our upper school students have chosen members of their own classes to serve on an honor council. The honor code itself says that a Lakeview student will not lie, cheat, or steal, or approve of those who did. And that honor code applies to everyone at Lakeview Academy, from the pre-K program all the way to the seniors, and indeed, we expect that of our teachers, ourselves, everyone who is here. That honor code applies to us all. But today, I wanted to push that a little bit further. It's not just about you being honorable, you being trustworthy, you not lying or cheating or stealing. That other part that says, or approve of those who do, it's kind of weak in our honor code, but it's very important. and its importance comes when you look at the constitution of the Honor Council, and when it says, why? Why not lie? Why not cheat? Why not steal? One answer is, it's your badge of good conduct. And that's very important. It's important that you are an honorable person. But our honor code and our honor council and our school are about something even further. And it says in our honor constitution that we are doing all that in order to build and maintain and become a trustworthy, honorable community. It's not just about individuals. It's about who we are and what we do together. You all know from other kinds of experiences that if one person in a family, or one person on a basketball team, or one person on a prom committee lies, cheats, steals, it's not just about that person. That affects everyone on that team, on that committee, in that family. And this is the part that I would like you all to remember this year. When you sign the honor code for ninth graders and new students, and for all of you, all the way to our seniors, who have signed the honor code in past years, we're here not just as individuals. This honor is something we share with one another, we recognize in one another, we support in one another. Remember each other this year, and I hope that we all here at Lakeview Academy can become a community of trust and of kindness. Now I would like to turn the signing ceremony over to the president of this year's Honor Council, Sarah Schultz.
Hi. The members of the 2016 to 2017 Honor Council were chosen by students to represent them in teaching and administering the Honor Code. This year's representatives are for the 12th grade, Jackie Wins, for the 11th grade, Drew Cottrell and Rachel Hendricks, and for the 10th grade, Jack Kennedy and Abby Piccolo. Ninth graders and other students since last year's convocation are now asked to come forward and find your name on the honor code sheet, which is arranged alphabetically. Ninth graders, please go quietly to the table at your left, and new students, come quietly to the last two stations on the table at your right. Once you have signed, you may return to your seat. We ask all others to be silent during the signing of the honor code. Students, please come forward and sign the honor code.